there are unreasonable. There are unreasonable. Anyway, the answer to the question would be yes for me. It may sound a little pathetic, any father will easy. Any father will easy sacrifice his life for his children. He's like a soldier guarding the peace of his family. And till he is on watch, we may be killed. While they are alive, with the children. Your father may have passed away, but you can still look up to the sky and wave goodbye. You cannot forget him, no matter what. But at least the sky has one more angle to say hi to, love, and miss you there.
Next, not place another word to us. You can have that much not for them. Also, the other is a hair John Buster. Hagamlar va tomoshabinlarni oldida avvalo ustozlarimga minnatdorchilikni bildirib qolaman. Markazdagi o'ylaymanki, chiqishimni yaxshi baholashib, qolgan ishtirokchilarga omad tilab qolaman.
So, okay, ladies and gentlemen, after we all have cleared up our minds, let's continue. Welcome our next speaker, the junior student at the second academic classroom under Uzbekistan World Languages University, Said Mubashir Shirin.
That's how we could find our inner peace. That's God, it's a beautiful view. And we need to be proud of what we can do by saying, sometimes I don't get things right, but other times I do a really good job. I'm the best. I could achieve everything. I can do something great. That is the best way to increase our confidence. And we need to write down qualities that we admire about and say it by looking at the mirror. Say, I look beautiful today. I'm a beautiful person. I can play piano. I can do something. That's really the best thing that you know about our world. To be spiritually healthy, all we should do is to believe. Our strong belief in something. Personal communication with God. Appreciating each day that we're blessed with can make stronger our inner soul. Inner peace begins with that moment when you don't allow situations to control your emotions. From this great topic, I have learned to be strong, even when I feel like crying. And I have learned to be positive, even negativity surrounds me. And I have learned to be peaceful, even when I'm at war. Because no matter what happens, I will not allow situations to control me. I don't give up. I keep going. And at the end, I would love to tell you that, ladies and gentlemen. Health is our real wealth, not pieces of gold or silver. Because when you have health, you have hope. When you have hope, you have everything. Your happiness, your family, your work, your joy. Everything is connected to health. Because health is our meaning of life. And I appreciate your attention. Take care of your health. Thank you.
Big sinoptiklik san'atida o'z bilmagan bilimlarimni sinab ko'rdim. Albatta, bunga o'qituvchilarning mehnati katta bo'ldi. O'ylaymanki, samarasi kuchli. Hayajon ham juda kuchli bo'ldi. Sahnaga chiqqanimda o'z notiqlik san'atimni sinab ko'rdim. Umid qilamanki, yaxshi chiqqan. Albatta, qolgan ishtirokchilarga omad tilab qolaman va ta'lim bergan o'qituvchilarga albatta minnatdorchiligimizni bildirib qolamiz.
Next participant, the junior student of the academic classroom named Dr. Sergeant Zin, at a bio-based MOOC. At a bio-based MOOC, optimism.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's my pleasure to extend a cheerful welcome to you all. So today, I hope you'll enjoy from my speech. If not, I hope you'll have a good nap. Could you see a glass of water? Yeah, I think it's visible for everybody. And I am sure that in this auditory, every people think differently about my action. Maybe you are thinking that I am going to show you a circus with the water. Actually, no. Or maybe you are thinking that when I get thirsty, I will drink it. Yeah, can be well. Or can you look carefully, half glass of water? So in that case, maybe you are thinking that I didn't fill the water till the end in order to not spill it. Yeah, it can be. So what I am going to say about differentiating your opinions, especially by questioning myself. So in general, in life, people's character and the psychology are different from each other. Yeah, it can be some similarities, but total similarity is impossible. And generally, they are divided into two categories. So optimist and the pessimist. So who are the pessimists? If I show it to the pessimists, they will think it's half empty rather than half full. And the people who prepare for the worst and reduce the expectations. By the way, I want to give you really good advice. If you need some money, always borrow from pessimists because they will not explain back. And the people who protect it from the disappointment and difficulties. As a quote by Winston Churchill said, an optimist sees an opportunity in every difficulty. And a pessimist sees a difficulty in every opportunity. So, and people who see it believe in absurdly and the painfully optimistic world. So, who are the optimists? Optimists have a tendency to make lemonade out of lemons, and for them it's known that made the mistake, it's no big deal, and there is another chance to repair. And being optimistic is really admirable quality, one that can possibly affect on a physical and the mental health of human. All the terms are philosophies and strategies. People also should choose their own strategy to their life, because it will be determined to of people's success, happiness, and the impact to the community to save the long. As is known, there are many people who could maintain the sense of humor and the optimism, and under circumstances that included poverty, starvation, and the war. And me, and other my teens, who had never that kind of hardships, they may have trouble only by depression, which makes feel sadness. So why is it so? And the obvious that there are most of people, when they are young, they often might wide open to discover everything as a child, but unfortunately, when they get older, they often close up. And even there is aphrodisiac statement that a pessimist is experienced optimist. So in that case, in your mind, dictionary will appear really common words. So how to stay positive? In that case, there is really common characteristics of optimist people. So to have a purpose of meaningful life and persistence, it means to try and try again to achieve success. And the self-reliance, it means you should count on yourself. In case of emergency, it doesn't mean you can solve all the problems if something happens. It simply means that you are such kind of person that you will never fall apart. And that, sorry. You see, I am optimistic. I made a mistake, but it's not easy. I will continue. So, and then calmness, it means not to be ups and downs in life. All the rejections and problems are temporary. It's something that which everybody experiences and it will pass. And then to be comfortable with your own skin, it's about that you should be comfortable with your decisions. Not all of them should be correct. Some of them can be a mistake and you may deeply regret about your decision, but on the other hand, you don't need to focus on, I wish I hadn't, or I should have. And then optimism has been proven to improve the immune system and the chronic disease, and help people to come up with the unfortunate news. And gratitude is also associated with optimism, and has been determined that grateful people are more happier, and healthier, and the... sorry, again, I will continue. The grateful people are more happier and receive more social support and less stressed and less depressed. And as we know, few outcomes are more important than staying alive. And the optimism also linked to life longevity. Do you know that the researchers found that every 10 points of increase of a people's score on their optimism scale, that the early risk of death is decreased by 19%. And the optimism is reacting to problems with the self-confidence and the high personal ability. Specifically, that optimistic people believe that the all problems are just temporary and limited in a scale and manageable. The power of optimism is really strong and it's the key to success. When we get depressed, we should focus on about three words. Life is good. People, just it's up to you. Just look around. It doesn't matter if today is perfect or not. Just look around. Pick up your hands and move your direction to the right. And even there is a great routine that just make your relatives and friends just speak about one positive moment of the day. It's really simple, but it has a huge impact to the mood of the day. And if it's raining, we should look for a rainbow. If it's cloudy, we should look for sun. And if it's a dark sky, we should look for stars and moons. Thank you, guys. Ana hozirgina notiqlik san'ati musobaqadan chiqdim, o'zimni taqdimotimni berib, juda ham xursandman. Glavniysi
asosiysi.
Asosiysi men uddaladim deb o'ylayman. Farqi yo'q, men yutamanmi, yutqizamanmi, lekin bu hali hammasi endi boshlanishi. Kelajakda ham men bundan ham ko'proq yutuqlarga erishaman deb ham umid qilib qolaman va so'z beraman. Navbatda tashkilotchilarga va eng katta Azimjon Husanovga men o'z minnatdorchiligimni bildiraman. Hammasi uchun rahmat.
Thank you very much. So now, Nana's speaker. The sophomore student in the academic lyceum under Tashkent Medical University, Ashmintino Madina. Ashmintino Madina, it's possible.
Thomas Edison. He conducted 1,000 failed experiments. Do you know that? I do know. Because 1,001st was a light bulb. Every failed experiment is one step closer to success. What drove him? What drives you? Imagination. It is that thing which is unique for everyone. And if you think that it is easy to find, I would say, not too much. Let me tell the story of my life. When I was 8 years old girl, I came to my mom, looked at her, and said, Mom, I want to be like you. She looked at me with a smile of happiness and replied, Dear, for some, it is possible. And I saw that thing, ladies and gentlemen. I saw the motivation. And the next day, I started to send experiments to my little brother. I was a cardiologist, and he was in my poor patient. I made fun of him. But it had been continued till that critical day, when I comprehended that it is too difficult way to be a doctor. Day by day, I saw that to be a doctor, you have to work hard. You have to learn every Latin expression from biology. And of course, be very smart with chemistry. One day, when I was crying that it is impossible to me to be a doctor, my mom came to me, gave her a and said, Dear, if someone could do, you can do it. And the next day, I freshened up. Even I used to go to that medical institution that I didn't want to go, but it was indispensable. You know that it is basic part of most people's personal lives. Most people's personal lives are filled with tasks that they didn't want to do, but they do them anyway, because they need them for accomplishing their dreams. And my step was also very true. I don't believe that there is something such as a wonder or a magic that makes my dream come true. And I don't believe that there is someone who makes my dream into a reality. There is no elevator to success, which should take stairs. But I can say, not only motivation, which is given by our family influences on us, but also that negative sort of people who don't believe in us, makes us turn into our lives. And instead of listening to that negative sort, I concentrate my mind on the people with positive mindset, who say yes to their dreams, who say yes to their future. And I believe that one day I will come to my mom, look at her, and say, Mom, I'm like you. And she will look at me with eyes full of pride and say, Dear, I said,
Good. Thank you very much.
Judayam qiyin va mashaqqat bo'lganida judayam hayajonni his qildim. Undan oldin ham, undan keyin ham, hozir ham haligacha hayajondaman. Chunki bu umrimda birinchi marta bo'lgan shunaqa qiyin va judayam kuchli bo'layotgan voqea hayotimda. Shunga men javob topolmayman haligacha. Lekin men eng yaxshi ezgu niyatlarimni keyingi mandan keyin qatnashgan va mandan oldin qatnashgan ishtirokchilarga tilayman.
And next, the main speaker. The University of the Second Academic Classes under Tashkent Railway University by Z. Brobek. By Z. Brobek, suffering leaves and happiness comes.
As we all know, the families, the main person in the family was a child. And just imagine the family. Just imagine the family without a child. The atmosphere of childless family is life. Also, the moment when the child is born, the family is born too. Oh, I know one family. I know one family. After 2 years from the marriage, baby was born. These 2 years were two centuries for this family. And the baby was very cute. He looked like a juicy peach. And also he was very curious and very playful. The family was very busy looking after for this little boy. And of course, because the baby made love stronger, days shorter, nights longer, the home happier, the past is forgotten, the future worth living for. And baby was expected by his grandfather more than his parents. Even the grandfather stopped to make attitude with his friends, and he was busy was playing his grandson. They played together like children. They ate together like best friends. They slept together like close brothers. And after some years, the boy started walking like Elaine. And when his parents asked, "Why are you looking like that?" he always replied the same answer that she was joking. At that time, his father understood that it wasn't a joke. And his father decided to carry him to the doctor. And when the doctor tested him, he said, "I'm sorry, I can't help you. I just can't. It's too late to treat of your son." And that time, his father was depressed and can't talk anything. And after a few days, the miracle had happened. The doctors make up one's mind and decided to help this child, and they called. When the family come to the hospital, suddenly the boy started showing his disagreement. And he said, "No, mom, please, no. Don't let me go, please, mom." And she started crying. One of the doctors come to the boy and said, "Hey, don't be afraid. Just relax. We don't need to harm you. We just want to give you the Santa Claus costume. Would you like wear it?" And the little boy stopped crying and agreed with the doctor. Fortunately, the operation went successfully. And after surgery, 3 days, the children had a fever and he couldn't sleep. And the third day, he whispered to his mom, at night.
Mom, Mom.
And when Mom looked at him, he said, it would be better if we trusted to the God, in spite of the doctors. And after weeks, the Santa Claus came to the hospital where the boy was taking a treatment. And all other the boys were playing the games and singing a song together with the Santa Claus and also getting a prizes. This little boy wanted to get the prize too, but he couldn't. He couldn't because of his injured leg. Also, he sang a song louder, although no one heard him. And unfortunately, he didn't get a prize. He cried because of his condition. And after 1 year, doctors decided to let him go home and continue his treatment. And boy's condition became more better, but he still couldn't walk without walking stick. And when he arrived, he was happy when he arrived home. But this happiness was too short, because his atmosphere around him, all of other boys in the streets laughed at him because of his walking stick and because of his leg. And his shame, he was embarrassed and stopped to go out. But doctor said that he should walk a lot, but not alone, of course. One day, this boy and his favorite aunt decided to go out. And his aunt took off his walking sticks from his hands and gave to his mom. Afterwards, she tried to make him walk with her assistance. She promised to support him. And first time his mother showed his disagreement and then didn't deny. And this activity repeated 8 days. After 8 days, the boy, as the first day, walked 5 meters slowly, and when he tried to look back to his mom, he saw his aunt too. He felt extraordinary feelings that he thought about riding a bicycle like other boys. He thought about playing football like other boys. Having heard this news, his grandpa bought for him bicycle and balls. After 6 years, he occupied the first place in the marathon. And nowadays, he became more stronger and more intelligent. And he just had finished his speech.
O'zimni suhbatimni tugatdim, ichdan chiqdim. Man birinchi aytganimda unaqa yodlaganda o'zim yo'q yaxshi yodlab kechqurunlari tayyorlanib unaqa uxlaganda hozir sahnaga 2 qadam qo'yib chiqishim bilan shunaqa qarsaklar orasida o'zim yodlagan hamma gapimni esdan chiqarib qo'ydim. Lekin nimagadir o'tga chiqqandan keyin odamlarni hamma ustozlarni sizga qarab ko'zlarida sizga ishonchlarini ko'rib qanaqadir ichda odamda energiya, shijoat bo'lib ketarkanda, o'sha shijoat odamlarni menga ishonchi ozgina bo'lsa ham mani o'zimni o'tda hammani ko'z oldida o'zimni tutib turishimga yordam berdi. Keyin qolgan odamlarga kelsa, qolgan spikerlar hammasi ular bir biridan ajoyib, hammasi bir biridan zo'r temalarda o'zlarini aniq bir birlarini takrorlanmas yo'llar bilan bir biridan o'tishga harakat qilishyapti. И man bittasini tirmoqchiman hammaga. Hammaga omad.
Next speaker, 8th grade student at 260 school in Tashkent, Shavkat Sarvar. Shavkat Sarvar, do not waste your time.
Just imagine a boy who is 16 years old. And he is asking his dad, "Dad, what will you present me when I turn 18 years old?" His dad answers, "Oh God, I can't present. I don't know, son. We will talk about this one because you have a long way until your 18th birthday." And then this boy becomes 17. And he is asking his dad again. But before this one, he has one problem. He is going to the surgery, to the medical treatment, with diagnosis of his heart. And he is asking his dad, "Dad, will I die?" And his dad answered, "I don't know, son." And when boy becomes home, he is 18 years old. He can't find his father. But he found the letter addressed to him from his father, and he started to read. "My lovely son, can you remember when you were 16, you asked me, 'What will I present to you?' I presented you my heart. So, what can we think about this boy? I think that this boy didn't have enough time to spend it with his father, even with his family, I guess. So, stop imagining. Let's go to my speech. So you have heard that my speech will be about don't waste your time. So, I think everybody can get on internet the proposal that time is indefinite, continued progress of existence, an event that occurred in apparently irreversible succession from the past through the present to the future. But I came here to tell my own ideas. So, I guess that we mustn't waste our time, because nowadays many people do not realize that their line on the church will not achieve their life goals. So, one example, how can we succeed if we don't know how important is time? It is not the time that makes us successful people. What about the valuable things? Everything that is valuable has its own robbers, including the time. There are many people who can steal your time. And we must recognize this kind of people in the crowd. And we must repulse them. In other cases,